Ole, it has been exactly 1 week since we sat in these chairs, and I feel like I've learned so much since then. I'm a different person.
That's right. Taking especially into consideration that this is our second take. So, yes, we are talking about the Sermon on the Mount, and it's almost the last, because next week will be the last episode on the Sermon on the Mount.
Yeah, it'll be hard to say goodbye.
but something that that is ahead is even more beautiful.
Right,
we'll
right.
see. Let me ask you a question that I usually ask. Mm-hmm. What did you learn from our previous episode?
Well, I encourage anyone who hasn't seen it to watch, obviously, because there's so much in there. But lastly, we learned the golden rule. Do unto others as you would have them do unto you. But I think that applies to criticism as well, because we should also criticize others in the way that we would like to be criticized. And really, at the end of the day, we probably don't want to be criticized all that much, so maybe we need to focus on, firstly, removing that plank out of our own eye, because I think keeping ourselves in check is a full-time job. So that's what we should focus on most.
Take a look in the mirror.
Exactly, exactly.
And then you will see yourself from a different perspective.
But, you know, Oleg, I feel that maybe the verse that we say that's the most difficult, maybe the least understood, is Matthew 7:6, where it says, "Do not give what is holy to the dogs, do not cast your pearls before swine." What does that mean? What's he talking about?
Yeah, in fact, we posted the article on our website, so I encourage everybody who is interested in that passage, go to our website and check it out.
Yeah, you break it down completely. Absolutely, everyone should read that.
Yeah. So what is especially important when we study the Bible, to look at the context, entire context, and not just grab one text from this place and then another text from the other text,
right.
Because the picture will be complete if you look at the passage.
Okay.
What is especially interesting about this particular passage, that Jesus most likely quotes a parable that was used by Pharisees and Sadducees at that time. In other words, they would say, and by the way, the Gentiles are dogs and swine. So what he's saying here, he's saying, you have heard that others say, the Gentiles are dogs and swine, do not give holy things to them, do not cast your pearls to the swine, but I say to you, if you, being evil, give good things to your children, how much more the Holy Heavenly Father wants to give good things to all his children.
You know, I had never heard that interpretation before the show, but to me it makes the most sense, because taken by itself, Matthew 7:6 goes in direct contrast to everything Jesus said about the gospel being for everybody. So I really like this interpretation.
But we will discover later when we continue studying the gospel according to Matthew how it reveals itself. But I'm also excited about our last study on the Sermon on the Mount.
Yeah, so how does Jesus end this great sermon?
Yes, he ends this great sermon with an appeal.
Like many pastors.
Like many pastors. But his appeal is very different to the appeal of many pastors.
Okay.
So maybe pastors can learn something from that appeal.
Okay.
And us can learn something from that appeal.
Right.
So I'm looking forward to our next study.
Absolutely. So what do people need to read?
Everybody needs to read, and you especially. Read Matthew chapter 7 completely. So start with verse 1 and read it to the very last verse.
We're going
to
cover the second half.
That's right. We will cover the second half.
All right, Oleg. I'm looking forward to it. Join us.